Pukekohe High School art teacher is leading a project which will see murals painted around town. These artworks will aim to bring awareness to the town's racist past and hopefully educate the community. Catherine Tamihere is hoping to get Māori artists on board and already has one underway on the first piece. She joins us now alongside artist Jimmy James Kouratoras, who is doing the first mural in this project. Morena Kōrua, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. How are you doing?
Morena.
Yeah, good, thank you.
Awesome. It's looking so good. We're going to get a little tour shortly, but Catherine, can you tell us a little bit about this project?
Yeah, a couple of years ago when I was on practicum here at Pukekohe High School, I stumbled across a book called No Māori Allowed by Robert Bartholomew, and it was just heartbreaking. It just, you know, details of hundreds of babies dying, tamariki between the 20s and the 60s, racial segregation, and just poor treatment and the inaction of council, I guess, and government, which kind of caused those deaths, and just, yeah, poor treatment. And so this is kind of a positive response to that history. And because you can kind of see the effects, I mean, you know, obviously it's not as bad, but you can still feel it in our town. And while whilst our town is this amazing little place on the outskirts of South Auckland, you know, we can do better. We can do better for our tamariki. And so this mural is to, hope, healing and harmony, essentially. And so,
It's so beautiful. It can be a little confronting sometimes to have these conversations, but this feels like a really lovely way of having a difficult conversation.
Yeah, exactly. And this is a way, I guess it's about, you know, creating experiences for our rangatahi to get out into the community, to serve their community, but then also to be educated at the same time and to educate their whānau and friends, you know. And I think the way forward is to educate everyone. And with New Zealand histories coming into the curriculum next year, this is like the perfect time to be able to set something up like this so that it becomes sort of like this walking tour of our local history, of the history of Aotearoa, you know, right on our doorstep. So it's really exciting. And I'm so glad that everyone is on board. So, yeah.
and Jimmy's on board as well, which is so fantastic. Jimmy, what drew you to the project?
Oh, kia ora. What drew me to this project was, you know, I was born in Pukekohe. My mother's born in Pukekohe. My grandmother's born here local. And, you know, they grew up in this time of this dark side of Pukekohe's history. And that drew me in, you know, that really drew me in. It pulled on some heartstrings of the hard life and the difficulties they had assimilating in society, and also kind of like how that's kind of riveted right throughout the generations with our names, with our and the choices that they've made, you know. And so it really pulled me in, and I felt like, you know, it was time to kind of acknowledge that and to transform that into some transformative healing for Pukekohe, especially our rangatahi and young people.
Yeah, Jimmy, how important do you think it is to kind of confront these things head on and have these important conversations and dialogue?
It's important that we acknowledge these parts of ourselves that are uncomfortable. I think there's great learning and a greater reward on the other side of these confrontations, shining a light on it and just healing these intergenerational traumas helps free us up and live better lives, not only within ourselves, but how we participate in the community and share that. I think like the more we shine light on difficult subjects, such as racism, I think we do bring about a common understanding that, yeah, we're all going through this together, and that we can all actually help each other and create better futures, especially for our young people.
Beautiful. Catherine, the young people, and we can see some of them standing behind you there in front of the mural. Tell us about their interactions with this and their understanding and what they're getting out of it.
Yeah, so a couple of weeks ago, Jimmy and Robert, they both came to our school to speak to our Year 10 art students. And these are some of our Year 10 art students who were interested in participating in this project. And they're here this morning and they're going to help Jimmy today. So the weather's lined up and we've got a beautiful day. We're so lucky. And so, yeah, so we're going to give them some paintbrushes soon.
I love it. They must be getting a lot out of this process.
Yeah, I think so. And, you know, like after this mural, we're going to have a bit of a debrief and figure out, you know, what they're thinking, what's going on and the bigger picture and what we can also do from here. I mean, we've got so many opportunities that this mural has opened up for us. And along the way, you know, there were, you know, the local Franklin board, Resene, Franklin Community Arts, you know, like we've had all these sponsors who have really... You know, like, I gave them the brief, I told them what they were about, what this project was about, and they were just on board, you know, so I can't thank them enough, and as well awesome. As our school, of course. Yeah. Our school's amazing.
Jimmy, just quickly before we go, we can obviously see the piece. Can you give us a little bit of an explanation of what we're seeing?
Yeah, we're looking at here a bright, vibrant wall. We're looking at Po, we're looking at te reo Māori, we're looking at unity, we're looking at Te Puia, we're looking at the Kingitanga movement, we're looking at Tainui Waka, we're looking at Te Whiki, teachings of Te Whiki, we're looking at Aroha and unity right here. Well, it's about changing the narrative. Changing our colour palette and brightening this town up.
Neat, yeah. You two. Love it so much. And Catherine, congratulations on the success of the first mural, and we cannot wait to see where you take this next. And Jimmy, it's epic, mate. It looks so good.
And kia ora.
A really important conversation to have. So thank you so much for joining us. That's Catherine Tamihere and Jimmy James Kouratoras. Thank you so much, both of you. Really appreciate your time.
Kia ora.
This morning.
Thank you.